Perhaps you're a little bit down, my friend. That your daily life is a bit humdrum. Boring, if you will. It's time once again for another nutnfancy.
That's nutnfancy.
Nutnfancy and tactical doodle knife review.
How's that?
Are we sponsored by like a cough medicine with heroin in it now?
That's a reference to the 1930s. Yeah. See, I got that one.
Back when America was cool?
Your dad ain't that hip, but I got that one. That's my 1930s radio announcer voice. It's better some days and not so great other days, but I'm working on it.
Sponsored
it's pretty
by
funny.
Pervitin?
Pervitin, you know what that is? I'm sure it's a valid reference.
I think it's like the methamphetamine analog they gave to Luftwaffe.
Perfect. Perfect. And now he's going to introduce our second intro. That was the first, by the way.
And here comes another Kalashnikov.
It's Kalashnikov.
Kalashnikov rifle.
There you go, dude. What do you think, TD?
Getting full view now after being in the background for so long.
Affirmative.
You really get a sense of scale in this one.
Yeah.
In the back, you think, it's probably just 1/6 scale or something. It's 1/3.
What?
1/3 scale.
What? Bring Battle Angel out.
Dude, it's huge.
Show her. This is War Angel Angela, our hot gal, fully armed up, tabletop bunker decoration. She's 1/6 scale. She's got an M4 carbine. You can see how huge this AK is. I mean, to a human, it's not big, but to her, it's massive. Yeah, she's a 12-inch 1/6 scale figure.
This is bringing back like those fourth grade arguments of why don't they just make like the same thing an AK is, but make it like way bigger?
Well, they
Wouldn't
did.
Wouldn't that be an anti-tank machine gun?
They listened. Let me show you real quick. And we're talking about Kalashnikovs, so this is our dumb intro. This is a super cool replica of the real thing. It comes in a kit. It's called a goat gun. I think some of you guys have it already. We'll put some links below. And if you can't own a real AK-47 or an AK variant rifle, you don't have the money, it's not legal in your locale, this is kind of a nice analog.
Yeah.
If you just like the look of it and just, a desk decoration, it operates just like the real thing. Look at the bolt. Look at this, dudes. So you take the mag out. It's got rounds in it. The mag release actually works. Look at that. It assembles like the real gun. Quality on these is pretty phenomenal. And there's a lot of different varieties. GOAT stands for greatest of all time, I take it.
Each round carries a 1 grain powder charge.
And it's so quiet when it goes fully auto. It's almost cute. It goes Macy hates it when I go full auto on her.
It's awesome.
Hates it. Okay, so nice. Kalashnikov on the tabletop decoration, kind of fun. And now we're going to talk about and morph into the discussion on the blade. TD loves this knife.
Love them. Love the series.
Yeah. You were telling me off camera that you EDC Boker Kalashnikov blades frequently on the farm. Is that correct?
All the time.
Okay, that's interesting.
And I'm surprised at how well the finish is held up. Even on the ones I coated.
Right.
Like, there's something about this finish that just that I think it's just able to take a coating really well, and it grabs onto it for dear life, because stuff I've coated in other, you know, G10 normally won't last that long under hard use, but...
That's cast aluminum, bro.
I know, I'm talking about the Spyderco's.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I've done multi-layer finishes, I've sealed them, and...
Here's a lightning with the kind of wear and tear that I love. I love when it gets chipped and knocked around. This is just a regular lightning out the front blade.
I love a good finish when I'm not the one who finished it.
It's a lot of work.
Like 4.5 hours of prep work.
Yeah, I love this yellow one. It's really cool. Okay, but the Kalashnikov. This is called the Boker XXL Kalashnikov. It's offered by Blade HQ. There are other versions out there. I believe they're called XL. But they decided to go one scale bigger, and we absolutely love this knife.
Smart move.
At the price level, it is a phenomenal value. It's kind of a no-brainer purchase.
Yeah.
If you like auto knives, I will say it's not my favorite Kalashnikov. This one is, our TMP collectible. But this is about second cool, doing the Hawkbill blade,
yeah,
TMP powder blue, specially designed nutnfancy clip added. Thank you, Boker. These sold super quick, gone way up in value. I love this one just because it's collectible.
There's a whole collector spectrum just on this design alone.
Oh, there is.
There's yellow. There's shark mouth thing. Right. So it's got so much character.
Right.
And it's rare that you have a lineup that has that kind of distinctive design language that from a glance you go, oh, yeah.
And the beauty about all of the Kalashnikovs is they're so affordable. Even this was.
Yeah.
The price we sold this for was ridiculous. They've like tripled in value, these ones. But, you know, we're just trying to cover our costs, make a couple bucks in the process. This is a small one, covered years ago.
Adorable.
So, TD, give me your main points as a knife nerd of why you like this one specifically, the Boker XXL, and I will show the blade.
Bigger size than most EDC knives. It's a size factor you don't see too often.
Correct.
It really reminds me in how it carries of that lone wolf.
Right.
The really big one.
Yeah, T2.
Back when RC. They used to make that. The coloration, it just hits so many things all at once and at a price point that pretty much anyone can afford.
Right.
And at a price point that you can afford to give away. Like you've given away so many of the other... I doubt you would be giving away a bunch of your Kalashnikovs. They're like 180 to 200.
No, they're affordable. We've given, I don't know, 10 away to TMPers over the years.
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah. It's great to turn someone onto it or, oh, you got a friend. Yeah, it's just awesome.
Totally.
You rope more people into the obsession. And the coloration is just a win. It's their Desert Warrior. It seems like they're doing some more special editions of that.
That's it.
It hits both the FDE and OD. Round all the bases at once.
Yeah, kind of the burnt bronze coloration, which you love.
Yeah.
Because when we were coating in the workshop, you went to this color all the time.
All the time.
You kind of overdid it.
Yeah.
It's like every time I turned around, I was like, damn, burnt bronze again?
Well, I bought like a liter of it.
Yeah. What do you think, radio announcer?
I agree. I would say damn too. Too much burnt bronze.
There you go.
Hey, if he's going to come back later, can you bring me some coating?
I'll ask him.
Sweet.
Okay, now if you buy an automatic blade of this size... they're usually going to be super expensive. If you don't believe me, go to Blade HQ, click around, you'll see. Now, by way of size comparison, I have a Gerber Applegate Fairbairn large fighting knife. This is a large knife. I reviewed this in 2009, y'all. And look, it's smaller than the Kalashnikov XXL TD.
Bam.
Look at that. That is... awesome. So that's one reason why we like it. We love the color combination. And I think Blade HQ has done this before. We've reviewed the Desert Strike. Here's a Kershaw. Which one is that?
The XCOM, I think. They're same finish. This very is affordable cool too.
Yeah.
It's like 28 bucks.
Oh, I'm going to review this positively. This is a great little knife. Kudos to Kershaw working with Blade HQ for this coloration. So it's the same theme.
Yeah.
OD, burnt bronze. Really nice knife. So we love the color. Now, it's also available for a few dollars less. Standard black and satin finished. You can get that. Of course, we recommend this one. Here's the thing, dudes. I don't know how long they're going to produce this. I've talked to Jake at Blade HQ, and I said, hey, this is going to be a hot seller. I would make this a kind of a continual thing, but who knows? Is it limited edition? I really don't know. But I would suggest you jump on it when you can. If you like this style of knife, a large auto knife, which I love. I should have brought some of our large auto knives to table, but I didn't think to do so.
This very much, I'm sure they're going to keep making it for a while. But I'm sure in 10 years, I'll look back on this and say, man, I wish I bought like 10 of those just to
squirrel away. They're freaking cool. Okay, let's talk about philosophy of use real quick. First up, collectible. It's just fun. Is it limited? We talked about that. Who knows? But it's just a fun, cost-effective, fun collectible. Knives, watches. This is a TW Steel, by the way. Great little watch. Are all about fun. It's about making your life, your daily life, funner. So is this video, actually. That's what it's about. So that's our first philosophy of use. Just something fun to clip to your pocket. However, I think it might be able to be employed in a skirmish.
There you go.
Did you catch that?
Yeah.
I said, skirmish. Yeah, so a tactical blade in a skirmish, I think it would do awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I'm not so sure that this is the strongest knife. You probably would want to go with a fixed blade if that's what you're after. But look at the length of the blade, y'all. 4.75 inches. That's a big blade. Overall weight, 6.5 ounces. I'm going to classify this as a tactical folder. Actually, a tactical auto knife.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah.
I love the clip blade. Love it. You know what it reminds me of? Two things. Mark I Navy knife had that deeply clipped blade. The Mark I Navy knife, if I'm remembering that right. I think I am. I took one with me to U.S. Air Force Survival School and SERI training. Great knife, by the way. It did great. And then it reminds me of a clip-bladed AK bayonet. Flat ground from this portion. This portion here is flat, so it will fit on your Edge Pro Apex. Awesome. Get this. Don't get too excited on me. It's not HCR. It's not OS 8.
Uh-oh.
It is D2. So it's an upgraded steel.
Sweet.
Upgraded steel, dudes. So D2, and you're getting it for around $60, and it's a freaking huge automatic knife.
And unlike something its size, you won't be afraid to jam it in a pocket with a tactical light.
Put some wear on it.
That's the thing.
Put some wear on this. It'll look cooler with some Boba Fett wear.
Yeah, I can't put my higher-end knives in the same pocket right next to my titanium flashlight. And oh, just that scraping when I know it.
Right. Dudes, you don't see TD's pockets, but he has like... You probably have four things clipped to your right pocket right now, don't you?
Yeah, in my right pocket. Do you want me to empty it?
Yeah, go ahead while I'm talking. Here's the speed on this. It's a bigger folder. Look at this. So that's pretty fast for a coil-fired auto with a big blade. The thickness on this blade is 0.12 inches, so it's just right. It's in that sweet spot. Comes super sharp. D2 once again. Upgraded steel. How many pins do you need to carry, by the way? Holy crap.
Each one's different.
Dude, you got one of these?
Each one different and better than the last. What is that?
0558? 58.
I think
you must have just started carrying this.
Mm-mm. It's a return.
Oh, there I go. Getting distracted by a knife. This is a TMP Cadet, by the way, if you don't know why I'm kind of geeking out on that. They're hard to find. Anyhow, back to the review. See, we're knife nerds.
Yeah, buddy.
For sure. We're knife nerds. There's an attempt at jimping on the cast aluminum handle. And it works pretty good, actually.
Yeah, but
it's not top-notch.
It's not aggressive and sharp.
I wish it was. It's kind of hard to do when they cast it. But, and there's some on the top spine here, but it's there.
You can do it yourself with a little rotary time.
If I was going to put this into the skirmish philosophy of use, then I would probably run skateboard tape on it, as always. And then I could extract it from the pocket and it would enhance my grip.
Look at Mr. Fancy Pants, who can afford to replace his expensive tack pants every couple months.
But you put it on the... I don't put it here. As I'm sliding in the pocket, I'm putting it out here. So as I come out... Here, I'll show you. I've got my Kershaw knockout right here. So this... Like that, dude. Now, I just have it on the end here so I can extract it. That's a great blade, by the way.
I love that one.
Freaking awesome. That's my EDC today. Making me happy. Yeah. Last time I looked, it's... I don't know if they make it, but it was in stock a couple weeks ago when I looked... I honestly don't know. I don't know. Let's look at the tip on this thing. Look at how precise that is, dudes.
Yeah, buddy.
Let's look at the centering. There's your lock bar. Look at this side. There's a lanyard hole there. That takes us to the clip. And I don't like the clip. I've always said this about the Kalashnikov series. It's just Wizard of Ozzy. Yeah.
I don't mind it.
I know you don't.
I don't mind it because, unlike many other clips, it avoids a phallic shape on the top. For some reason, I can put up with this. That would
be a bench made reference.
This dimension, okay. Cool, whatever. As long as it doesn't look like a dong hanging out of my pants. Because that happens sometimes.
1930s announcer man, do you like it?
I hate it.
Boy, I sure do like wieners.
So it's 2-1. Oh, we hate it, you like it. That being said... I wouldn't change it. I mean, it's fine. I just wish, maybe I don't, but I'll explain in a second, that they would have put the TMP clip on it. The reason I was a little confused there is I don't know if I want them using this clip on a non-special edition. Because that keeps this one special.
Yeah.
So I take it all back. Just keep it this way. The nice thing is it's thick enough to take your tactical pants. There's no screw intrusion right here. It attaches on this end.
And it doesn't spin.
And it's oriented as God intended it, tip up.
Well, look, I love how they fix it in position.
I have no issues with
none of this, like, multi-screw thing, and then if they fall out, you...
He rants about this off-camera, by the way.
So much.
He talked to me about this for like 5 minutes. I was like, okay, you can say that, but you need to like shorten it up. And he's like, okay, there you go. We love the knife, highly recommended. We really have no competitive offerings to show you in this price category. No,
nothing.
Coil fired auto at this price, forget it, ain't there. You could go some manual actions that of course would be, you know, possessing of the same first cool. I don't know about the second cool factor. Tell them real quick what we got on the table, by the way.
These are the old die-cast Star Wars, I think the Jedi Starfighters.
Show it to them closely.
It was the,
these are cool little toys.
Because in the prequel trilogy, you see, everything has to somehow tie in and be the ancestor of something in the original trilogy.
Right.
That guy in the background of the bar, turns out he's the bartender's nephew from A New Hope.
Oh,
what a crazy coincidence.
Sakes.
And this was, for some reason, the Jedi were driving TIE fighters.
That being said, these are great little toys. How long have we had these?
2005, I think. I bet
okay.
you.
So, yeah, check this out, dudes. Little winglets fold.
The wings fold. The little canopy opens.
Yeah. Did it come with a figure or no?
Mm-mm. They never made them.
What scale are these? They look like 172nd. I had a 172nd troop on there. There he is right there. He's by the biplane. Check that out. So 172nd dude carrying a wounded comrade. That's sad. Yeah, that's a 172nd scale.
He's not wounded. He just has food poisoning. They went to Taco Bell.
Interesting. Taco Bell does that to me too. Those are cool toys. Cool toys. Anywho, back to the knife. A Boker XXL Kalashnikov Blade HQ Special Edition. Highly recommended. Nutnfancy TD. Thanks for clicking on the video. Hopefully your day is a little bit less boring now.